the whole concept of how MCs worked off of each other, like back in the G. Now was my thought on how I was gonna work the Hot Boys. A modern day Furious Five. At the time, it was the leather thing that they did or whatever, but it was the uniform. Everybody had the same thing on. Everybody moved as one. It was the bandana, the long white tees.
Damn, dog, you Furious Five, me, dog. So I'm Melly Mel, then, huh? They're like a jungle. I can't be nobody else but Melly Mel. Damn, I didn't know that's how he saw that. The look is the Magnolia. Before we even got around, did anything with cash money, we was wearing T-shirts, Chibos, and Reeboks. We got packs of T-shirts and packs of rags and boxes of soldiers. Man, we would show up to an event, and they'll see us earlier that day, and they'll think we had the same clothes on. Yeah, oh, man, that's bad. We got to change our wardrobe.
Man, look, what kind of nigga just dressing all black? Fitted hats, low flats, folks look like the tech.
Hold up, what kind of nigga ride 20-inch chrome? Turning off his clothes, cause hoes don't want to leave them alone.
We all hot boys, we fires that can't be put out. You could call every fire engine truck in the United States and let them wet us down, but we still gonna burn. We still gonna burn.
It was undeniable because all of them were dope artists, dope rappers, dope lyricists, and you had the sound that Mannie Fresh had introduced, which was bounce, but with a twist. You know, you just won't get rowdy with it. And that resonated everywhere. People like that raunchy sound, that let's get wild sound.
They did a big impact with the Hot Boys. Everybody wanted to be like them. With the white T-shirts and the Jabos on, everybody with the do-rag on, nobody didn't want to put no suits on. They did so much independently. I mean, like, a lot. Well, when you selling a lot on your own, record companies start looking at that.
The whole record deal with Universal, it was a shock to the music industry. Like, they didn't understand that we was gonna put out these amount of albums, the quality of the sound. Like, they didn't know really, like, who are these cats? What did they do to get $30 million? It was a fun time for us.
How the hell are you out there?
Put the light on them bitches. That's 100 G's, player. You see the bling in them? Get a good shot of them, cousin.
Cash Money was always known for a flossing label. The stunting thing came about when the big deal came. The world knew that Baby and Slim signed and had a lot of money, and Baby also got the opportunity to really come front line.
Now, Cash Money is solidified. You had BG fans, you had Lil Wayne fans, you had Turk fans, and you had Juvenile fans. They gave everybody a platform to build everybody else's career off of this. Now we're gonna really break y'all down into solo artists.